Hey, how you doing? I'm Jerry Bryant here at the JBTV studios. And, you know, we have an archive here, an archive of tons of tapes. And all these tapes, see all these tapes right here? All these tapes have so many memories. And, you know, there's this person in the news that I think it'd be fun to see one of their first performances here on JBTV. And it's really cool. I'm going to keep it a mystery, though. But anyhow, Fizza said, you know, Jerry, I think it's time that you do a little something different with your television show. Like, why don't you do a long-form show? And I go, a long-form show? Really? You know, anyhow. So, at my home studio here, I guess I can do a long-form show. And, you know, one of the long-form shows that I think would be fun to do would be for this awesome female artist, you know. And, you know, what's really cool about JBTV is that over the years, for 40 years, I've been doing television shows, you know, just for the love of it. And I'm going to show you raw footage, and this is all Fizza's fault. Remember, you're going to blame Fizza if this show, you know. But we could use some more followers and subscribers and stuff like that. And better yet, just share this episode. It's a long-form show, so sit back, you know, do what you got to do to relax. You know what to do. And you're going to see the load in. You're going to see a sound check. Let's see what else you're going to see. Well, I can't show you the whole the performance. I'd love to show you the whole long performance of the whole 150 people. It's a very, very exclusive audience, you know. But here it is, Charli XCX. And, you know, she started out, can you believe this? In a small van. And here she is driving up right now. Charli XCX right here. Long form. On JBTV, raw footage, unedited, raw, well, a little editing, raw.
Don't seem to understand my treatment.
We'll make this happen. Yeah, so maybe pull up like a little bit more.
Good.
Perfect.
Just the question. Yeah. Hey, guys, how you doing?
How you doing,
man? You're all right.
So it's just drums, keys, tracks, and vocals.
That's it, man. Yeah.
Cool.
Drums are in, though, right?
Drums are in. You'll probably have to tune them up, but.
Okay, have we got until like 2:30 or something?
If they're supposed to hit at 2:15.
Nice.
Yeah, I know. we'll push it back a little bit, but obviously we'll make this as quick as possible.
Of course, yeah. Question on
part.
Go down. They,
We've got a ton of hardware up there.
Hey, he needs certain things for the pads on the chest in, man.
Okay, cool. So we'll just bring the whole fucking thing.
They got a shitload of hardware upstairs. Do you want to take those up as well?
We've only got one snare stand, but
yeah, take it, okay?
Cool.
Never heard.
How you guys been?
Yeah, cool.
Good man. Oh, like the weather?
Well, I'm definitely not singing it for them. But, well, whatever, you know, I'm sure it's a good song. I'm sure if they take it, they'll travel really far.
All right, let's go.
So I would rather it went with them.
Cool.
He's right.
He's gonna come up front.
Yeah, they do. In their
No, they do. Moses is cool.
They're doing this like new version where they're like singing. I love it.
So, yeah, it's okay. They're asking for the part, but maybe we should give it to them until they got the band room last minute. Because otherwise it might get messy. And the only thing is, there's only 24 channels because two of the channels are stereo. So we can't use that.
Patrick's like waiting on, Patrick's waiting on the shellback version to share. I was trying to push to get the parts to Iconopop, but we didn't have enough channels to do overhead slide and stuff.
Those four DIs up there, the rack DI up there, that should cover it. you just do red, white, blue, so all us Americans would understand?
Yeah, no, it's just so we can remind them.
Up here at this corner, that power source is probably your best. This power strip right up here, that's a separate circuit.
Sweet, what the board is on?
Sorry, I'm going to shut out amps for just a couple seconds.
I don't mind even holding it. We're going to do the interview right afterwards.
Guys, we'll do this.
I think so, yeah. Low cut.
Thank you.
three. Oasis, the same thing. You know, Garbage.
Yeah.
You know, so.
Wow.
Been doing it forever. So like every band on this wall has played JBTV or done an interview.
This is so. And so cool.
It's like it's kind of like the real hard rock, you know, where like
everyone
did something.
Wow.
So, and then back here, what's cool is everything gets put in.
This is crazy.
Everything gets fed back here into the isolation you just want. We'll be mixing here. So, yeah, everything gets fed back here and isolated. So then he can make it sound better, and then, you know, and he fix anything that needs to be fixed, the artifacts, whatever. So,
thank you. Hi.
When they do a hard turn show, I can like hand show and you can see what's up on.
Over here,
the basically like everything that's
whoa.
Goes back. He's got like PIL, he's got like crazy stuff. Like Midnight Oil, Lollapalooza from 1993. Like it just goes way back.
This is insane.
Four Non Blondes.
Oh my god.
Katie Field, Linda Perry. Yeah,
I worked with her.
Oh, you did?
Yeah, she's, I mean, like a genius. She's amazing. This is so cool.
Yeah, so we're in the process now of like digitizing all this and getting it online on JBT Online and having an app. So the app will be kind of like a Netflix or cool. Yeah, Flaming Lips. Yeah, like a Netflix or a Spotify. So you'll be able to like create your own music video channel, like in the band you like, and then it'll bring up all the music videos from JBTV. And it's like your own personal music television channel.
Wow.
Yeah. Charlatan, 92.
Yeah. I mean, that's when I was born. Crazy.
Oh, God. Oh,
they were going to be shipped here.
Yeah.
Oh, cool. Well, thank you.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you.
Okay. You or I'll take it. Okay.
You're getting a full treatment today.
Check this out. Crazy shit going on.
Ah, but you haven't seen the craziest stuff yet. Ta-da!
Hi.
Hi. Hi. I'm Jerry. You're Charlie.
Mm. Nice to meet you.
Pleasure meeting you too. Welcome to JBTV.
Thanks for having me. It's cool here. I like it.
Yeah. You probably never played a real stage like this though. You played hundreds of clubs and all kinds of interesting areas. But nothing like JBTV.
No, nothing like JBTV. But I like it, though. It's nice. It's cool.
Yeah. Now, actually, during the show today, you had to verify someone's license.
Yeah, yeah.
Has that ever happened before?
No, that was a first. But, you know, like, everyone's always like, it's my birthday. Play this song. He was like, it is my birthday. I was like,
And you actually got the license to prove it.
Yeah, right? Yeah. So that was cool.
Now you got to hold it hostage for him, right?
Yeah, exactly. Thank you so much.
Black roses!
No, take my hand, please.
That's his birthday. It's my birthday, Charlie.
It's my birthday.
Is it your birthday, too?
Yeah, it's my birthday.
Okay, it's take my hand.
It's your birthday.
My birthday too.
better really be your birthday. God, the driving licenses are coming out. It's his birthday. All right, take my hand, it is.
So Charli XCX is in the studio. This is an awesome edition of JBTV. You're playing live on our JBTV HD stage.
Mm-hmm.
Give me some background on you.
Well, I guess I started making music when I was like 14. Mm-hmm. I was posting demos online and I got contacted by this guy who ran a lot of like illegal warehouse raves and stuff.
Illegal?
Like that. Yeah.
Whoa.
Illegal. In East London. And I kind of became part of scene.
Mm-hmm.
And it just kind of grew from there really, and then I kind of got a manager and all that stuff and just put out my record, and I've been touring and it's kind of going mm-hmm. kind of cool, I guess.
You want to know, at the very beginning, did any of those get busted by the police or anything?
Yeah, really? Yeah, totally. There was one which was really scary, like, and kind of uncoolly, I went with my mom and dad to these raves. So they were like there with me at like 4 a.m.
It's really legal, parents.
Yeah, exactly. And there were these like, this one time where this like gang came in with a load of like Rottweiler dogs and like pit bulls and stuff. And then the police had to come. And it was really, that was kind of scary. I was like, let's go now. It was kind of
You're safe on stage though? There wasn't any chance of you getting bit or anything, stupid.
Right, I was good. Yeah, it was pretty crazy though.
Because, you know, right at that early age, you could have been doing the best music ever mm-hmm. and have it cut off.
I know.
You know, because of some stupid thing. You know?
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, tell me about how you write your music and everything.
Well, my writing process is really all over the place, to be honest. I don't have a set way, but it's very spontaneous. Like, it's just kind of when it comes to me, it comes to me. So if I'm walking down the street, I have to like, mm-hmm. you know, like,
now, how do you save these awesome ideas?
Yeah, I sing into my phone. I think everyone does that these days, but then sometimes I just keep it in my head. And because if I'm not sure if it's a good idea, I keep it in my head. And if it's still there a week later, then I know it's a good idea. So wow. It's kind of messy. Like, I don't have a set way. It's all over the place. But all I know is that all the good songs are written in like half an hour.
Yeah. Like, so the ones you really got to like, I got to get the song written right away. It takes you forever and it's not really the real deal.
No, no. It's the ones that are just like, boom. Like I wrote this song for this band, Iconopop, called I Love It. Mm-hmm. And that was written in half an hour in a hotel room, like before I had to go to another studio session. And that's kind of blew up, so yeah.
You're helping other bands,
like
by writing songs.
Yes, yes.
That's, you're really generous with your work here.
Oh well, I mean, I know what I want to do with my project, which is, I guess, I want to make emotional pop songs and weird kind of like still pop songs, but you know, like kind of, I don't know, like luscious, like beautiful pop songs. And just my own like weird little world of pop. And I want to write hits for other people and I enjoy doing that. So why not?
Well, good. She's playing live on our JBTV HD stage right here, right now after the break. Charli XCX on JBTV. Good. I got that in right in the, I was waiting for the sound to come in because he's already starting to mix it here at JBTV. Because we record everything isolated, all the different instruments and everything.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah.
Cool. Now, do you have any equipment endorsements or anything yet, or?
Well, I'm not really like
For the band, you know.
Yeah, yeah. My band do, but they kind of deal with all of their stuff themselves. And I think like Virus are helping us out, so shout out to Virus.
You don't want to get a virus.
but like Premiere as well. My drummer works with them, so yeah.
It's so cool that you have all that going on.
Yeah, it's cool. It's cool. It's great for them because they're always like, whenever we drive past a guitar center, they're always like, get me in guitar center. And my drummer's like playing on drums for hours. And I just go into like the kind of like disco DJ room and kind of hang out there for a while.
I can only do so much with my voice and it's all natural and there's no one.
They do like cute mic stands. And
now you have an awesome mic stand. It looks like it was custom made. Tell us about that.
Yeah. Oh yeah. I mean, it is like,
I wanted to have like a party and a mic stand, but I also wanted it to be kind of like super slick. Uh-huh. And eventually I want my whole stage to look like Tokyo. That's the idea. Really? Like I'm at the moment getting this mic lead made, which is going to have three different kind of neon like colors in. Oh. So the mic lead's going to light up. And it's funny because everyone is always like that. Everyone's like to me, you know, oh, why do you not use a wireless mic? And some people are like, oh my God, how budget, she's using a mic with a lead. I'm like, what are you talking about? Like,
it's the best, it's quality.
The best. Yeah. Like having a mic with a lead is the best. So, and I love the lead. So I'm going to emphasize that and make it glow.
Yeah, because that would be cool to make that happen. Plus, it's nice to hold on to the cable when you're on stage. And you know, these wireless mics are so unpredictable. Sometimes they sound awesome.
Yeah.
And then you're on stage, it's like, what happened to this awesome sound?
Right, I know.
You know, the only thing they give you is freedom. So you could like, you know, crowd surf if you ever wanted to.
Yeah.
Which I don't think you'd be doing, right?
Well, no, you know, I've never crowd surfed, but I will. Like, it's definitely on my bucket list. Uh-huh. Yeah.
Well, at the next show on the bucket list, yeah. Crowd surfing. Now I have a few things to give to you here at JBTV.
Oh, really?
Yeah, do you like gifts?
Yes. Yeah. Who doesn't? I love gifts.
Yeah. Well, I got such an intimate gift that I think she's going to like this one. And I know there's very few of these left, so I can, you know, give this one out, right? It's a JBTV limited edition sticker.
Yes. I love stickers. Oh, it's you. There you are.
And it's me.
I'm gonna stick this on my car when I get home or something. Yeah, great. Or maybe just write here or something.
Oh, there you go. That's a perfect place for it.
I don't know. This is very cute. Thank you.
But, you know, anybody can get out stickers and stuff. You know, I think I have something a little better for you because you seem to be a little technically involved with music and with social media and everything.
Yes.
Is this correct?
It is correct. It is correct.
Now, what do you use for that now?
Well, my phone, I guess.
Your phone?
Yeah.
Oh, come on. I think we can do better than that.
Really?
You know, if you're using the phone to take pictures and stuff, I guess it's okay. But I have a gift. I think it's going to be a little better than just a phone. Okay. Now, this is something that you can use on your tour. You can write songs with it. You can put instruments on it and everything else.
Wow.
Yeah. It's a mysterious piece of equipment that I have right over here. And it's courtesy of Mac Mall and JBTV. It's a brand new iPad Mini. Gosh.
Thank you so much. This is so cool. I feel like it's Christmas or something. Thank you.
Santa Jerry here.
Amazing. Thank
you. It's 90 degrees in the middle of summer here at JBTV, but it's actually Christmas.
It is. Thank you. You guys, this is the best. You guys are so cool. Thank you so much.
Well, you're so cool. Oh, absolutely. Whoa. Hey, we're out of steak. Let's try it this way. Yeah. Oh, I like that a lot.
Thank you.
Charli XCX on this edition of JBTV. We just gave her a brand new iPad, a JBTV sticker, and if that's not enough, I have Greg Corner in the studio who's now going to come over here and actually ask some real questions that are real probing, right?
No, hey, you probe pretty well.
Well, I think, you know, I know. He's next right here, right now.
You want to get set? Cool. All right, Greg Corner back in the studio with Charli XCX from England. You mentioned growing up going to raves. Did you have like a favorite DJ or a favorite producer that you wanted to go see, or your parents were dragging you there, correct?
Well, no, they weren't dragging me there. I mean, I was getting booked for shows there, so I was kind of dragging them, but they ended up really liking it. Okay. But I mean, at the raves, it was kind of like a family, like everyone knew everyone, like it was kind of like the same bands and the same DJs every week. And I began to like really listen to a lot of French electronic music when I was in that scene, and it kind of like inspired me to really become a musician and like take it seriously. And I was really obsessed with the record label Ed Banger.
Oh, yeah,
I was like obsessed and still am with all the artists on that label. Like,
what do you think of the new Daft Punk record?
You know, I haven't heard it yet, but I'm gonna download it now.
It just came out today.
I've been reading like reviews, and obviously like I've seen all that hype after Coachella and everything. And but yeah, so I was like really obsessed with every like artist that Busy P was looking after, and like Uffy in particular was a real influence to me. And yeah, that's the kind of stuff I was listening to at that time.
And how did you get discovered by like these promoters? You're saying you were putting stuff up on YouTube and stuff like that?
It was on MySpace, and I don't know. Like one day I just had an email from this guy called Chaz, who was in this band called The Coolness. Just like the worst band name ever. Like he knows, I think that. And yeah, he was like, you should come play our parties. And it was cool, you know, like at the time I was really like so in awe of the whole scene. But I think as I kind of got older and I spent like a year doing those shows, like I realized it's very, I don't know, sometimes it's not about the music, it's very
about the party.
It's about the party and the fashion and who you're photographed with. And yeah. I kind of got sick of that. And so that's why I decided not to play those shows anymore. And it kind of came at a good time because it's when I got signed and yeah.
So what was your, you know, like when you first started writing, what were you writing on? Did you start on keyboards, guitar? Like
when I first started writing, that was when I was 14, and I guess I didn't really have like an identity in my brain. I was just kind of experimenting. So I was doing, you know, stuff on like the guitar really badly. I'm really terrible at playing this guitar. And the piano, like I learned the piano from a young age. So I was writing a lot on the piano.
And like, what was like the, like, did your first song you ever wrote, what did it ever come, did you ever rewrite it? Is it, did it ever see the light of day or no?
No, it was probably terrible. I did write one song when I was 15 called Set Me Free, which is actually on the record. And I think that's quite, I mean, everyone says it's the best song on the record. So I don't know what that, maybe I'm getting worse with age. Who knows?
Well, the worst part is if you release that when you're like 15. And then you blew up with that, and then you rewrote it, then everyone would ridicule you because, you know, it sounds better now, but they're used to it, how it sounds in the demo. Yeah. That's like the like a bad mistake you can make. Uh-huh. So, you know, I kind of pop. I love it. I mean, yeah. I've been playing that song for like a year and a half.
Yeah.
And I've been like, and I discovered the Manners EP by I Kind of Pop. Now, how did you like meet up with them? Because they live in, you know, Sweden, in Scandinavia.
Well, I met them really briefly in Sweden, like once. I think they were like loading into a gig and I kind of walked past and I was with Patrick and he was like, this is like Come Pop, and they were like going this way and I was going that way. I was like, hi, and that was it. But I mean, with that song, I was in Sweden for one of the first times doing a session, and Patrick Berger, the producer, sent me a couple of beats. One of them was like a rough version of I Love It, and I kind of freak out about like writing in the studio with people I don't really know. So I was like, look, I'm going to just stay in my hotel and write over this. So I did it, and I wrote the top line and the lyrics and the melody in like a half hour and went to the studio. I was like, hey, I've got this song. Like, I don't know, what do you think? And he said, it's amazing. And I knew straight away it wasn't for me because I couldn't picture the music video in my head. And that's
That's how you do it.
That's how I know, you know? And so we were like, we got this great song, no one to sing it, problem. And then a week later, Icon of Pop came and heard it, and they cut the vocal on top of my vocal, and that was the song. So
I mean, I heard it and I'm like, it's undeniable. It's an undeniable hit. And it's funny because it took like a year and a half to like hit over here.
Well, I mean, it's like the gift that keeps giving. It's like going and going. And I mean,
you wrote it in a half hour.
So old now, you know, it's so old, but I feel like new people are hearing it every day. And I mean, like, I feel sorry for Sweden because they must be so sick of it, because I think it's still...
Well, I've been DJing it for a year and a half and it got good response, but as soon as it like got on the girls soundtrack and like and all that, then it kind of like blew up, and it's like, you've been hearing this song like for a year and you never reacted, and now that it's on TV, everyone's paying attention.
I know, it's crazy.
They can just appreciate the music when they first hear it, you know?
I know.
So what was your first concert? What got you into music?
My first concert was the Spice Girls. Yeah, it was, I think it was the day that Jerry left, which was a really sad day for me. I guess when I was younger, it was Britney Spears and it was the Spice Girls and Aqua and people like that who made me want to sing, I suppose, you know, which I think is cute. And I think that those, I'm still a really big Britney fan. Like, I think some of her songs are incredible, you know?
Yeah, I mean, people nag on like, you know, if somebody gets into music through One Direction or, you know, Britney Spears, and they're like ragging on them. Like, no, if they're getting into music, that's the most important thing, whatever avenue it is.
And also, you know, I mean, I think that some Britney Spears songs are amazing pop songs. Like, I have no shame about, you know, the music that I like. I think if it's good pop music, it's good pop music. Like the stuff that like Danger Hands was producing, like, you know, Gimme More and Pieces of Me, that's amazing. And like obviously Max Martin's like a complete genius as well on that whole first record. And you know, it's funny like when you listen to it because it's like so 90s pop now, like all the
You get it doesn't date that
line. but yeah, no, totally. But
what pop music, you know, it's hard to not like, because it's always like, even Madonna, you know, she's always ahead of the trends with, you know, whatever is in the clubs. And then, you know, eventually it's, sometimes it ages well and sometimes it doesn't, you know?
Yeah.
I don't know how the dubstep stuff is going to
Think that's going to age terribly. I'm not the biggest dubstep fan.
Me either. So, yeah, I'm on your team.
Yes.
all right. So, as far as like, you know, your music and where do you see yourself going? Like, what's the next step for you? Like, what's, you know, because like, you know, you're kind of like, I wouldn't say anti-pop, but you're not traditional for sure.
Well, yeah, I mean, I'm like the biggest fan of pop music ever. And it's funny because like with my record, I from day one always wanted to write a pop album. Uh-huh. And I think that's what I've done, because like all of the songs on the record are pop songs, they're pop melodies. But I feel like I was saying, it's like emotional pop music.
It means something.
Yeah, it does. And I feel like a lot of the problem with top 40 music right now is that everything's so flat, like emotionally flat. And it's kind of, you know,
a lot of times it's been written by somebody else and not the artist playing.
Totally. But so for me, like my goal and where I'm going, I guess, is like, I just obviously would love as many people as possible to hear the album. But you know, I'm not one, I don't care about like sales or any of that kind of stuff. Like, I just want my record to be recognized as a album that began to kind of change pop music back to something more real and something more beautiful. And I feel like that's why people like I Love It, because it's like passion in a song. It's like anger, and you know, it's not just bleh.
Yeah.
You know, so yeah, I mean, I'm starting writing the second album. Right.
Have you been approached by like Britney or any of them to write their on their records? Because I think that's coming.
Well, I
can't say,
but maybe.
Yeah. I think it's coming.
Yeah, I mean, I'm writing for other people at the moment as well, which is kind of stressful because it's like all of these crazy people, like a couple of people, I can't say any names, but you know, heroes, and I'm on tour and I'm like, why am I on this tour? Like, I want to go and write with so-and-so, you know? It's kind of a funny situation, but it's cool, you know?
Any dream collaborators that you'd like to work with? Or have you a producer maybe that you want to work with?
Yeah, well, I would love to work with Emil Haney. I'd also love to work with Elof. And then artist-wise, I mean, Gwen Stefani would be a dream. Yeah. Bjork would be a dream. Dreaming big. I don't know.
I think you're already touching like some pretty heavy hitters. So I think that's coming.
Thank you.
Right. Well, you're amazing today. Thank you so much for taking the time out and doing the interview and the performance. Charli XCX Live coming up next on JBTV.
So did you have a good time with Greg?
Yes, it was great. It was brilliant. Brilliant questions.
But I got a question. Where'd you get these awesome shoes?
Oh, these are from, these are online. These just from online. They're like original, like 90s dead stock shoes. They've got a hole in though. Now.
Oh no.
I know. I wear them every day and I'm really worried that the hole's going to get bigger and then I'm going to have to get
crazy glue.
Yeah. I need some like massive, amazing glue situation.
Or you know what they use in the rock and roll business?
What?
Gaffer tape.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. I mean, I don't think they use that in the fashion business, though. But... No.
Well, you know, if you put some little stars or things on there.
Yeah, totally.
Now, what does the XCX stand for?
Well, it stands for Kiss Charli Kiss, and it was my MSN screen name when I was like 13, 14, and I guess it kind of just stuck. So.
So you took it.
Yeah, I took it. I owned it. Yeah.
Good job at that.
Thanks.
Cool. Well, thank you for being on JBTV. It's been an absolute pleasure that you've been here. Charli XCX on this edition of JBTV. We'll have links at jbtvonline.com. Follow us on Twitter, Facebook, and a lot more. So until next time, this is Jerry Bryant from the Windy City, downtown Chicago, saying bye-bye, stay high. And but of course, keep on rocking and rolling with a whole pile of great music from all different genres on this edition of JBTV with Charli XCX. Cool. Now let's get you to sign some of these awesome posters you brought here.
Okay, cool.
Here. This is an awesome, awesome picture here, Charli XCX, and you're going to sign this for our wall here at JBTV.
Yes, cool. Where? Anywhere?
Anywhere you want.
Okay. Right.
You can put it down so it's easier for it to do.
Do it right here. Cool.
Awesome. Can you sign a few more for our studio? And put one, make it out to JBTV, one of these posters. Cool. Yeah. So here we go. We got one that we're actually going to give away on the air. Greg, we should have some kind of contest for this. What do you think? Yeah, maybe we can donate some of that. Well, we'll figure it out. So stay tuned. We'll have a Charli XCX.
Yeah.
I'm going to put, that's so many. Wow.
Well, you're a big star now. So, you know, the more songs you write in 30 minutes, the more posters you're going to have to sign.
Yeah, I know. And these two.
Yeah.
So what you got planned for the rest of the year here?
The rest of the year, well, I'm on tour. I'm on my headline tour, starts in June in the States. And then I think I'm back in the States in September as well.
Uh-huh.
For a month doing like a full headline tour. Mm-hmm. And with a show, hopefully.
Oh, wow. So you're going to have all kinds of...
Well, the mic lead will be there then, definitely.
So. You're going to have your custom mic stand, of course.
Yeah, of course. Yes, cool. Yes. So I'm excited for that.
Wow. Well, we can't wait to see you on tour throughout the entire country. Now, what have you liked best about America so far?
You know, I really like the driving, actually, like, because we're driving everywhere in this gross van. And I love, like, just going through all these, like, crazy landscapes. And it's really relaxing. And, like, especially, like, around Denver, it was kind of crazy. Like,
yeah, all the miles.
Yeah, it was cool. Like, I really liked that. I like that.
America's quite a place to see.
It is. Yeah. It's big.
Yeah, you don't think we're big until you really know how big we are.
Yeah,
you know,
totally.
And you look at the cities like Chicago, New York, L.A., packed with people. Mm-hmm. Then you got these vast areas around the country that are just desolate.
Yeah, it's crazy.
Yeah. Cool. Well, have fun in America. We can't wait to see you back on your big tour, your headlining tour. That's going to be awesome. And you're making some new videos and stuff too, or?
Yes. Always making videos every day. Uh-huh. And I mean, I would love to do a video for every song on the record. Mm. So
go for it.
Happen. Yeah.
Do it. Cool. Well, stay tuned. Charli XCX on this edition of JBTV. She's coming up next, playing right here on our JBTV HD stage. Okay, let's get one with the IO.
Damn.
Keeps fucking up my exposure here.
Suitcases. Do you need a blue suitcase, Charlie?
Going.
Well, there you go, Charli XCX. Did you like the show, huh? Hey, we need subscribers. We need followers. You know, spread the word about JBTV. I mean, come on, it's been a hobby for 40 years, and I haven't really done much with social media. But you know, what can you do? I'm an old guy. So anyhow, till next time, it's Jerry Bryant saying bye bye, stay high. But of course, Charli XCX. Wow, just to have had her on the show at the very, you know, it wasn't at the beginning, but, you know, anyhow. Bye-bye. I'll see you next time. How do I shut this thing off?